Ladies and gentlemen, here's my mommy and daddy from FM Flip.
Together in the daytime, together every night, on the job or during playtime, working side by side.
I never cut up, I try to shut up when you're wrong. I know that you're stupid, but an arrow from Cupid keeps me struggling along.
Working together, birds of a feather are. You wanna do it your way, I wanna do it right. You nag and pester me all day and belittle me through the night.
Your mental condition, your lack of ambition hold me back. But we're partners in business, we're marital prisoners, and no.
And I know I probably shouldn't mention it now because we're working together and everything, but I've got to say something about it, okay? There aren't too many things that I expect from you as a husband, but I'll tell you, I do expect food in my stomach, clothes on my back, and the kids out of my way. Now, I know what you're going to say. You're going to tell me that you work. Well, let's be serious, can we? This is not a job for you. Hey, it's a convenience. I do all the work here. I write the skits. I work the puppets. I do the voices. I mean, all you gotta do is just stand there, you know, just put in time. You stand there, look semi-human, that's fine. Is it too much for me to expect you to take care of things at home? Is it?
Quiet, please. We're on the air in 5 seconds.
We'll talk about this later.
Hey, kids, it's the Brownie, Beak, and Sally Show!
Hi, kids! Hi, Beak!
Hi, Sally! Hi, kids!
Hi, Brownie!
Oh, hi, Sally! Hi, kids! Hi, Beak!
Hi, Brownie!
Aren't they cute? Kids, have you ever noticed in all these shows that Beak and Brownie never talk at the same time? Isn't that amazing? Today is a very special day because Beak and Brownie are going to talk at the same time.
What's she talking about?
Come on. You guys are real, aren't you? I mean, the kids out there believe you're real, and you wouldn't want to let the kids down, would you? Come on.
Well, Sally.
Yes?
It's not very polite for both of us to talk at the same time. And we believe in being polite.
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, boys, I don't think you're very polite. I think you're rude. And you know what we do to rude people on this show?
No, what do we do?
You know, kids, today's a very special day, too, because Beak has got a new trick for you, and he's going to do it right now. Can we have a close-up here on Beak, nice and tight? There he is. Come on, Beak. He's going to wink for us. Come on, Beak.
What?
Come on, Beak. Well, Brownie, can you do it? Could you wink for us, Brownie?
I'm just sitting here feeling good, you know, feeling fine. I just enjoy life, really. I don't really get into winking that much, you know.
No, I don't suppose you
or
do.
Or blinking. I just kind of, I'm just there, you know.
Kids, if you think this show is phony, it's because my husband had a hand in it.
Bye, kid.
Bye, kid.
Say you're the boss, your partner asks for a raise.
Birds of a feather nesting together is just for birds.
Thanks, kids.
Thank you, and please welcome our guest, Miss Carla Sherré.
You should know me, I've always been in your mind. You know I will be kind, I'll be guiding you, building your dreams as we start. It's promised in the air, and I'm guiding you through every turn. I'll be near you, come anytime you come, and catch you when you fall, I'll be guiding.
Morning, class. Today's lesson concerns the shape of the world. That's right, the shape of the world. Now, really, I shouldn't even have to discuss this subject, but there are a small number of imbeciles, and I'm quite sure your parents are included in this group. Anyway, these people believe that the world is round. Of course, it's absolute rubbish. Filthy, filthy, trashy stuff it is. The world is flat, and I think I can prove it to you today, beyond any reasonable doubt. Take a look at the floor under your feet. Is it round? No, it's flat. Put a ball on the floor. Does the ball roll? No, it doesn't roll because the floor is flat. If the floor was round, the ball would roll. The ball does not roll. The floor is flat, flat, flat. The floor is flat. Nor do you roll around on the floor. Not in this class. Nor do we roll around outside. Because the world is flat. If the world was round, we would roll. If the world was round, in fact, we'd all be at the poles. And I don't elect to be at the poles. Take a look at this globe. If they had made this globe flat, which they should have done, like a map, flat like a map, it would just lie on the desk. But no, they made the globe round, so it has to be held by these handles. Now, I've traveled extensively all over the world. I've never seen any handles. Maybe Sudbury. That would be it. There are no handles because the world is flat. And this is going to be flat in a minute if I don't stop that. So just let me say it's flat, okay? Now, there's another way to prove this. Take a look at the distance between Toronto and Vancouver. Perhaps I should put that on the board. Right. This is Toronto, this is Vancouver. If the world was round the way I've drawn it, it would be shorter by road than it is by air. In other words, it would take longer by plane than it does by car. This is simply not the case. Unless, of course, you go Air Canada. Now, you might say to me, but Christopher Columbus thought the world was round. Yes, he did. He also thought Jamaica was China. Blithering twit. Anyway, I should not get myself too excited here. I just wanted to say one thing in conclusion. I'd like to quote the famous and well-respected bard. You know who the bard is. Sir William Shakespeare, who said, "All the world's a stage." Now, I have spent a great deal of time in the theater, and I can assure you the stage is perfectly flat, flat, flat. And so is the world, and so is your Aunt Fanny. Get out of here!
All that talk about travel makes me think of a vacation we once went on. We decided that we'd really like to, you know, get away from it all, something really quiet. So we went to a little place called Blue Sea Lake, and it's in Quebec. And there was nothing, no television, no radio, no neighbors, nothing. After 3 days, we were climbing the walls. I won't say that I found your company boring.
I didn't bring my company.
But I did drop to sleep quite often.
We did get a little tired of it. There was a little town nearby, Maniwaki.
Yep.
It's a great name.
Maniwaki, the toddling town.
The toddling town, I guess you'd call it. And they had a theater there.
Yeah.
So we thought we'd go to the show.
Go to a movie. Brighten up our life with a movie.
There's only one problem. The movie was, of course, completely in French.
And we weren't.
We thought there'd be, you know, English subtitles or something.
Something.
We know some French, you know, and we should speak
actually,
French.
After high school, we thought, well, this is a really good chance to test out our French, you know. We'll try it out. We were conceited about it, weren't we?
We were. We went in there. The movie was, what was that?
McCabe and Mrs. McCabe Miller.
McCabe and Mrs. Miller, right. Yeah. Anyway, we sat there. We didn't have any idea what they were talking
Not
about.
Not a clue.
But we were really bored, so we just sat there anyway. And then I got up and went to the snack bar, okay? Now, the girl behind the snack bar does not speak English. My problem now is, I don't want her to know that I don't speak French. She's going to wonder, what kind of pervert is this? He comes to the show, he doesn't know what it's, you know. So I was going to order Smarties or something. I didn't. What is Smarties in French? Le Brainies? I don't know. I don't know. Anyway, it was quite an experience.
I think I'll have an experience now.
Oh, fine. Reservoir. Here's Morag. Clappy, 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 clappy.
You'll never know how much I love you. You'll never know how much I care. 'Cause when you put your arms around me, fever that's so hard to bear, you give me fever. When you kiss me, fever. When you hold me tight, fever.
fever, that is something you all know. Fever isn't such a new thing. Fever started long time ago. Bless my soul, I love you. You better take these arms away. Take this heart, I'll never use it. But believe in what these lips have to say. You give me fever. When you kiss me, fever. When you hold me tight, fever. In the morning, fever all through the night. Sun lights up the daytime, moon lights up the night. I light up when you call my name, 'cause I know you're gonna treat me right. You give me fever. When you kiss me, fever.
We're here at the Comedy Club this week to see Rick Green.
Hi, friends. Barney Turnpike here at Barney Turnpike's Turkey and Toothbrush Emporium. Here at Barney Turnpike's Turkey and Toothbrush Emporium, we have everything, from turkeys to toothbrushes, and they're all priced to move. Gosh golly, look. Here's a Tom turkey that looks almost good enough to eat. Almost. And speaking of dental care, how about our official Barney Turnpike toothbrush? Huzza, huzza, it's even got bristles. But wait, friends, there's more. Also specially priced this week, only at Barney Turnpike's, are our very own turkey-handled toothbrushes. Boy. Boy, who would love to get one of these as a gift? But wait, friends, there's more. Also marked down are our super deluxe toothbrush and a turkey. Yes, it's all here. Just eat your fill of fowl, then cleanse big hunks of meat from your teeth with the strategically located toothbrush. Value? Convenience? You tell me. And if you order, you get, with each purchase, the Barney Turnpike Turkey and Toothbrush Tool Set, which includes, at slight extra cost, a generous assortment of one toothbrush, attractively packaged inside of its own simulated leather, sticky wet turkey. Fun? Wow. But wait, friends, there's more. I've also marked down, just for this week, our very own turkey brushes to brush big hunks of teeth from your turkeys. Well, we're located right in the heart of our location. So come see our turkeys and toothbrushes, won't you? Why not?
Small, we used to laugh and play and have a ball, and we would often say, let's have it all and try and live this way our whole life through.
But there's no fun in a factory and no big laughs in the ministry, but this here gig is our cup of tea.
Neural surgery.
Oh, we love to get our hands on your brains. Oh, mercy. We love to drill holes in your head, snap off your ears, blow out the carbon, and change them all to left-hand thread. We love to have a chance to take the top off your noggin and rust-proof the pulmonary vein. You'll likely take about 1,000 fits when we finally get to the end of your wits, 'cause we love to get our hands on your brain. You take your liver, it's a tasteless bore, and so's your spleen, whatever it's for. And large intestines, well, say no more, it's a full stop at every colon.
Now we hate lungs, a complete disgrace, and messy hearts squirting round the place. But call on us to go behind your face,
we're listed under mental case. And we love to get our hands on your brains, oh mercy, there's really nothing we'd rather do. Tune up your memory, air out your cells, take 100 points off your IQ. We love to have a chance to take a boo at what you're thinking and clean off the shampoo stains. It would surely make you sick if you could see what makes you tick. But we have both been independently trained. The lessons came in the mail from the college for the casually insane. They've never had anyone fail, and we're the only graduates they claim. The rest are all in jail, and we love to get our hands on your brain.
And help us thank Carla Sheree and Rick Green.